Play the most ancient game. What does it mean to be self-actualized? This is the top of Maslow's hierarchy. Maslow's hierarchy is something that is kind of misunderstood. It's one of those things that's been repeated so much it's believed to be an ironclad law of human nature. In reality, the pyramid that Maslow came up with wasn't the result of any kind of scientific study. He asked all his well-off friends what they thought was the most important things in life. So Maslow's hierarchy is something a lot of financially successful people think is important. But consider this idea. Supposedly, you can't really achieve the upper levels until you satisfy the lower levels. Food, safety, sex, love, esteem, contributions, etc., and then self-actualization. But what happens to those higher levels when the lower levels vanish? Like if there's a natural disaster and you don't have any electricity or heat, what happens to your self-actualization when you're freezing and starving? That phrase, self-actualized, sort of sounds like you've reached some kind of peak human. But what if this isn't true? What if self-actualization is not really a destination but a rare combination of many ever-changing variables? What kind of variables? Let's do this from an imaginary, objective, alien perspective. Let's pretend we know nothing about humans other than what we can observe. And us aliens have had secret cameras recording humans ever since humans became humans 200,000 years ago. Certainly we'd note the main transitional points. But what could we say about humans that is the same regardless of the time period? What do humans do now that humans also did 100,000 years ago? Same brains, same imaginations, same desires and fears. How about we compare humans to all the other animals? Some animals only wander around eating other animals. Some animals operate solo, others in groups. Some animals build things over and over. Beehives, anthills, beaver dams, etc. So humans are social, but we also build things. But we don't build the same things over and over like the other animals. We seem to look out into the world and build more. Better things, cooler things, safer things, more enjoyable things. And critically, we humans trade with one another. We've done this for tens of thousands of years. We do it on the playground as kids. Not only do we trade, but we use an intermediary potential energy. We sell our stuff or our skills for this potential energy. And we keep that energy until we see something we want. So what is our purpose according to our pretend alien objective view of ourselves? We participate in this trading tradition. The better we do this, the better our lives are. Perhaps this is the key to self-actualization, to play this ancient human trading game as best as we can. To learn more, visit mindpersuasion.com/financial-brilliance.